Now the Michigan man, Jake Moody, to get us started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. It's Swift to start the drive. And he's got a good gain of 7 up to the 37. So from the 37, here's 2nd and 3.
A 7-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 3 at the 37-yard line.
Once again, it's Swift. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. The play fake. Here's Hurts rolling to his right. He completes it to Julio Jones. He is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. A good pickup there, 26 yards. So from inside Niner territory now, this is 1st and 10 at the 27. On 1st and 10, it's Swift. And he fights forward for a modest 2-yard gain, 2nd down.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the Trash Man. His ability to sift through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker. 2nd down and 8. Here's Hurts to throw. This is Smith with a grab. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the 5. 19 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have it 1st and goal.
1st and goal at the 6-yard line.
On the option left, it's Hurts. And maybe the wrong read there as he's going to go down immediately. Now from the 9, here's 2nd and goal.
At the 9-yard line.
Hurts sets up to throw it. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
It hasn't been a real good start to this game from a defensive perspective, but now after the incompletion on 2nd down, things may be changing. If they can come up with one more play, they might be able to get out of it with just a field goal attempt.
This will be play number 8 on the drive. It's 3rd and goal. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. Oh, he had him. He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield, but when push came to shove, they stood their ground, and now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
The kick by Elliott is good, and the Eagles, they take a 3-0 lead. Well, after marching down the field, only getting 3 there, kind of feels like a win for the defense.
And it does. They'll go to the sideline feeling a lot better that they didn't give up a touchdown after the march against them. But if I were the offense, I wouldn't hang my head over that one. That's a good drive, and 3 points were put on the board.
Returning from his end zone is Ray McLeod. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked out officially at the 21. Purdy going to lead the 49ers to the line, 1st and 10. At their own 21. They start on the ground with McCaffrey. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's 2nd down.
Nice chunk of yards on first down. It really opens up your options for what you want to do on second. You go right back to him and hope he explodes or sucker the defense in before throwing over the top.
Purdy now on second down. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete.
Kind of a fine line when you set up the screen. You don't want to throw it too early and have the defense react too quickly. And you definitely want to throw it too late. And that way it's not formed perfectly. Got to make sure you hit it just right.
Able to find the open man. That's complete. Now inside the 25, Deebo Samuel. Touchdown, 49ers. Deebo Samuel. 75 yards. And the 49ers have answered that early field goal to take a first quarter lead. Well, Charles, here in their opening series, they said they had certain plays scripted for certain players. That looked like a well-designed play to get one of their top targets involved.
Yeah, let's face it, Brandon. A player of his talent is a problem for any opponent to defend, and we saw it right there. They tried to deny an open lane to him. He still outplayed the coverage and scored the early touchdown. Good luck trying to figure out how to defend him as this game moves on.
And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put six on the board. That's a consolation prize. Like going to the county fair, you don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
Second down, here's Jalen Hurts. Toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more attention on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
So a failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a third and eight. Throwing is Hurts. And he is caught, and he'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. 18 yards on his first catch of the game. It's a first down.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere, and they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well, and that's what they just did on that play.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. That sack was by Isaiah Oliver from his cornerback position.
It's second and 21. At the
after one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports.
With the score, Niners 7, Eagles 3.
Now second quarter action from Philadelphia, and it's the Eagles in possession as they've got it facing a second and long situation. Hurts. He'll buy some time right. And he gets his down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. He turned that into a nice gain. Gets him 8 yards closer for third down. Just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. And the Niners get there and bring him down. The defense rising to the challenge and sending him back on the sack.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
On is the punter man as he boots this one away. And no return here.